Hey friends, I'm Tasia, and this is your Google Keep tutorial for beginners. So you might be wondering, what is Google Keep? Google Keep is a note-taking, list-creating task manager from Google, and it's completely free. There's a lot of reasons why you should be using Google Keep if you aren't already. So let's jump into how to use Google Keep. So part of learning how to use Google Keep is understanding its features, like collaborating with others, customizing your Google Keep home screen, and so much more. So first things first is how to access Google Keep. You can do so from the Google Keep mobile app, or one of the easiest ways to access it is directly from any tab in your Google account. So whether that's Gmail, GCal, Drive, and so on, you can find Google Keep on the right-hand side of your screen here. It's the little yellow square with a light bulb in it. Alternatively, you can also head to keep.google.com to access a full screen version of your Keep account. So let's work off here for this tutorial so we can go more in depth. On the left-hand panel here, at the top is Notes, and under that is Reminders. And then directly underneath those is where you can view labels and create or edit labels to better organize your notes. But I'm gonna get into more details on this left-hand panel in a little bit. So here in the main section of your screen are gonna be any notes or task lists that you've created. But right above that is this text box that says, "Take a note." This is really where you can get started on creating and organizing new notes and tasks or reminders. So click in the text box, and here you can add a title to your note and then start writing out your note. So this is why I find Google Keep really handy. If I'm on a client call and I need to be taking notes when I'm on that call, I can be doing so right here and typing in all the important details as we're talking on the phone so I don't miss anything. That way it's stored digitally and not on some notepad somewhere that I'm probably going to misplace or forget we've talked about. So here we are typing in our new note. And once everything is in, you can either organize or customize the note right from here as you're creating it with these little toggles right here. Or you can just click off the note and it'll appear in your notes section of Google Keep right here in this main screen. So now let's dive into some of those great features found within a note. Hover your mouse over the note you've created to access that row of options along the bottom. In the left-hand corner is a bell symbol. Now, this is where you can set a reminder, which is so handy if you need to follow up on something later and you don't want to forget about it. So to set a reminder, just click that bell icon, and you can set it when you want to be reminded, but you can also set a place to be reminded. So go ahead and click pick a place, and you'll have to give Google Keep location permissions in order for this to work. So once you've done that, then you can just type in the address of the location. So imagine you created a packing list, kind of like I have here, it's for your hiking trip or something, and you can pick the address of your favorite outdoor store, so I'll put that in here. And now Google Keep will send a notification of your packing list when you arrive to the store. How neat is that? So now let's talk about the collaboration feature. This time when you hover your mouse over the note, click on the collaborator icon. Then in this pop-up here, you can add a person or email that you want to share the note with. This is another feature I love because again, if you're on a client call, you can be the designated note taker or you can assign somebody to be a note taker for your call. And then that way they can just share all of you that were on that call with those meeting notes. So just add those you want to share to the note and click save. And you can add as many people as you want and they don't even have to have a Gmail account. So they'll actually get an email notification asking them to collaborate on a note. You'll have icons here indicating those that are shared on the note. And of course, you can have different people collaborating on different notes. And by the way, anytime you're editing a note, just click off of it to get out of the note. So here you may notice in my example, there are different colors to my notes. So one is this like teal green color, one is plain, and so on. If you click on the change color icon, you can simply select a new color. Now, this is handy if you're into color coordinating your notes, kind of like if you're into calendar blocking on Google Calendar, you can kind of do that same visual cue with Google Keep. So you could make, you know, a specific client a specific color. So to the right of the color picker is the option to add an image to your note. Again, if you're big on visual cues and organization, you can just click on that icon and select an image from your computer and it'll add it right, bam, to the top of the note. Now this next feature is the archive option. This is not the same as deleting a note entirely. So archiving is really good for when you're all done with a note or task list, you can just archive it. It gets removed from your main page here, but if you select the archive option on the left-hand panel of your screen, you'll have all of your archived notes right here. And don't worry, if you archived by mistake or say you have to reopen a note or project, if you just hover over that note, now you'll have the option to unarchive it and bam, it'll move it right back to your notes section. So you can of course fully delete a note if you want. So just click on the three-dot menu icon here in the note and select delete note. Now this will move it to your trash bin, which you can access again on the left-hand side of your screen. And then here you can either manually empty out your bin, but notes do automatically get removed from your trash bin after 7 days. So I'm gonna head back to notes at the top here so we can go over more features. Hover your mouse over the note again, and this time click that menu in the bottom right again. And the second option here is the option to add a label. Now, I mentioned this a little bit earlier, but this is really key for organizing all of your notes. Think if you just had thousands and thousands of notes floating around here on your screen and you'd have to manually search for anything and everything, it would be a mess. But if you add labels, you can quickly find anything you're looking for. So go ahead and click Add Label. And here you can either create a new label or add it to a label if you've already created one. And now on the left-hand side of that screen, you can quickly drill down your notes per label. So now you don't have to search through everything. You can just search by that label. Plus, all of these little customized features we're adding will be viewable at a quick glance of your note. So it's like adding like custom tags to every note. So this one is tied to an address, for example, and this one is labeled work and so on. So I'm gonna go back to my main notes page here and I'm gonna hover over a note again and click on more options again. So here you can also add a drawing, and this opens up a window where you can add a custom drawing to your note. Now, it seems a little silly, you know, what you would use this for, but let's say you work better by sketching out a layout or a logo idea or something like that. This could be a really good collaboration tool. So back in the more options section of your note, you can also make a copy of a note. Now this is handy if you're gonna be making similar notes. Rather than create it from scratch every time, just make a copy of it and it'll copy the note over and the label over. So things like location you can see here and collaborators will not be copied over. It's kind of like when you're working in Google Docs and you make a copy of a doc that you know is gonna be really similar and then you can just take out what you don't need and add in what you do need. So another feature in More Options is the ability to show checkboxes. And this is handy if you like to check things off your to-do lists. You can actually click and complete the tasks off your list as you go. I prefer this view for a task list, but you can also go ahead and hide those checkboxes too. Now the last option in this More Options section is to copy a note over to your Google Docs. If you click on this option, your note will automatically be copied over to Docs and you'll have all your info right in here too. Now, we talked a little bit about labels and how powerful of an organizational tool they are, but if you want to edit or delete a label at any time, you can click on Edit Labels. And in this pop-up box, you can click the pencil icon to the right of a label to edit the name. Or hover over the label itself and you're gonna see the trash bin will appear to the left of the label name. And you can select that if you wanna delete a label altogether. Now, a couple of other things to keep in mind is that you can change this complete layout of your Google Keep page. If you click on the rectangles near the top right of your screen up here, you can actually toggle to a list view if you prefer it to a grid look. I prefer the grid look, so I'm just going to toggle that back. And then there's also a settings gear in the top right where you can enable dark mode. So if you're working at night and you don't want a bright screen, you can change the view to dark theme. I do recommend you also click into your settings from that settings gear here and explore some of the other options for organizing your notes. Now, let's say you're working in the mobile app and you've made a note, but for some reason you can't find it here on your desktop when you get back to this view. You can just hit this refresh button here near the top right and your mobile note should appear. So keep in mind, all of this we did directly from keep.google.com, but if you're actually watching this video, you will recall how I said that Google Keep can be accessed and used essentially from any tab in your Google account. So here's how that looks now that you have an idea of this Google Keep ecosystem. I'm gonna head back to my Google Calendar here. And to the right, I have that little Google Keep icon. I'm gonna click on that icon and this side panel opens up. And this is where you can create a new note or list, see existing notes, edit an existing note, all right from this tab that you're already in. So this is really the main way I create a lot of notes and lists in Google Keep. I basically live out of my Google account, so I'm either in Gmail or GCal or Google Docs. So as I need to quickly create a reference note, I can just do so right here without having to open a new tab and lose my place or train of thought with where I'm at. I definitely recommend taking advantage of that Google Keep shortcut. And keep in mind, you can always do any of this, what we just talked about, from your Google Keep mobile app. So that's how to use Google Keep. And now I want to hear from you. What are some of your favorite Google Keep features and why? Let everybody know in the comments below. As always, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, I want to know. So give it a like, a share, or leave that comment below. You can click right about here to subscribe to my channel and here for even more videos. Thanks for watching, guys. See you next time.